Hey everyone, we are about to go live real quick. Let me go live on Facebook. Give me a second. Let's see. Clients and building legacy. Get this going. I'm so excited to share with you our topic today because it's something that I've thought about, but I've never thought about it like we're going to talk about it. So let me get this going here so that people inside the Facebook group can see this. Long-term thinking. All right, give me 2 seconds. 2 seconds. Okay, now let me go into the group real quick and change something. Okay, so if you are just hopping on the Zoom call or you're watching on Facebook today, first of all, you guys want to say hi to my like little puppy dog? Okay, so my name is Cheryl Spengler and I go live every Wednesday at 3 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And our number one goal is to help us all grow our online business. And it doesn't matter what you do, consulting or coaching, real estate, even if you're just a fix and flipper, whatever kind of side gig you do, this content will help you. So if you, so I'm glad you're here. And of course I'm getting a lot of views on YouTube and people who are seeing it on LinkedIn. And starting next week, I'm actually going to be going live on 4 platforms and inside this Facebook group on this content, simply because there's a lot of people that need to hear some of this stuff. And I just want to get more, people aware of some of the content of the 14 weeks is what I'm mostly concerned about. Okay. So you guys know that I have been recapping the 14 Bezos letters. And if you don't know what a lot of the topics are coming from, it's coming from this book here. So I read this book and it really, really impacted me. And I want the content to impact everyone, like to think bigger. And it's definitely made me think bigger. And today is something, okay, so today's title is called Long-Term Thinking. And we have all gone in November and done a annual, you know, like our projections, our quarterly. If we haven't, then, you know, you need to do a business plan, right? But it's always called, let's do next year's business plan. And even that doesn't get done, truthfully. Like we may write some stuff down, but we never like go to the end and write down what we want, the year to be, and then back it out down to like, what does that mean we have to do for the quarter? What does it mean we have to do for the month and then the week and then the day? So really that's what the business plan should be. And we're all focused on that, but basically this chapter, this day is about really thinking long-term. So in the content that I read and reviewed and thought about there, the question is, what is the value that you're creating in the long-term? And we're talking like 100 years from now. I have a story to tell you guys. First, it's something that I read that I didn't know. The next is something that happened to me this past week that really, really impacted my long-term thinking I'm doing right now and how people are resonating with that. And it's actually bringing me business just by doing the thinking. Okay, so the first thing is, what is the value that you're creating in the long-term in your business right now? I ask myself that question. What is the value I'm creating in my business right now? So I have the marketing business and my Cheryl Show, which focuses on enhancing social connectedness. And I call that a business because it is. I'm running it as a business. I'm running it to make money And that is literally not the purpose of it, but I'm running the show as a business. You know, what people want to know before they decide to be a guest. You know, what value do they get? What value is a viewer going to get? And so I asked myself on that respect, you know, because I always ask myself these questions in my marketing company, but I always try to give a different perspective. Like a different perspective is something where it's not a product or service, but a show is so off the wall to think of in some of these examples that I give. That's why I use it as an example, because we all have some type of product or service, but if you want some kind of like outside the box thinking, I always give the show example. So what kind of value am I creating in the long term by doing the show? Or if your business, what kind of value are you creating for people where you will never be even alive to see their value? Like, what is your legacy? But even though I named this group clients and building legacy, I didn't mean what is the legacy you're gonna leave your kids. Because we always think of legacy as like, oh, what are my kids going to get in money? What are my kids going to get when I hand them a business? Like, what are my kids going to get? But it's more like, what is your legacy to your clients and their clients and their clients and their clients? What is your legacy to future employees that you may never meet because you won't be around? And I never really thought about it like that, because I'll be honest, I have been someone who's been a short-term thinker, meaning I've tried a lot of things. Although I've been in real estate for 22 years and I've been doing online marketing for 8 years, gosh, that actually flew by. I didn't start out thinking I'm gonna start this for the rest of my life. I really didn't. And even though now I do think that, I still initiate things on a short-term mindset. And this chapter, this content made me think completely different. So, what will my future employees get in value for what I'm doing right now? Well, I don't have employees right now. I have contractors, right? Subcontractors, meaning it's like 1099 people that I hire when I need them. But if I had future employees, what would be the value they would get? And so it does make me think different, because I've always been the proponent of don't hire employees, hire contractors. But that's just one example. So I want to tell you this story about this inventor, Danny Hill. And if you already know this story, if you've already heard this, then you're just going to hear it a second time. Basically, there's an inventor, Danny Hill. He's a scientist. And he built something, a 10,000-year clock. And what prompted him to build this is his frustration with everyone who was obsessed with the Y2K bubble, right? He was irritated with everyone's obsession back in 1989 with Y2K in the year 2000, but like no one talked about beyond 2000. They were always like, the computers are gonna reset and break down in 2000. Then it became called the Y2K. But no one really said like after 2000. And so actually this is really current, like within the last 24 months. I can't say that. Like in 1999, he was frustrated, but somewhere between there and the 4 years after, he decided to build a 10,000 year clock. So let me tell you about this. It's powered by sunlight. It resides in Texas. Guess who bought the land mountain that it sits on? Jeff Bezos, for $42 million. An investment in land and a mountain to house the clock that will run for 10,000 years, powered by sunlight. It ticks once per year instead of our clocks ticking once per second. And the century hand ticks once per 100 years. And then there is a cuckoo. Okay, I don't know how it's gonna come out or make a noise, or it's powered by sunlight. There's a cuckoo that comes out once every 1,000 years. Think about that. So like basically once every millennium. So most of us will never make it to even the 100 year tick for them. So it's like, well, why do it? And literally, he says part of the why he did it is, one, he wanted to really think really, really long term. Like, his goal was, I'll read you this one little section in here that is just kind of like his explanation of something. But I like it because it kind of makes you think, like, what could I do that would be like that? He says, over the lifetime of this clock, the United States won't exist. Whole civilizations will rise and fall. New systems of government will be invented. You can't imagine the world. No one can. But we are trying to get this clock to pass through it. And it's like, that really makes you stop and think how short-term thinking we are right now, where we are so obsessed with quarterly earnings and annual revenue. I mean, not annual revenue, because obviously that's important, but I would say quarterly earnings and monthly. Shit, some people are, a lot of people are worried about paying their rent or mortgage next month. It's really hard to think long term when you're focused on paying your bills or keeping your employees from losing their homes because you can't pay them as much, or you got to let them go, or you got to downsize, or you got to take their hours away. I mean, you're basically, we're all caught up in like the COVID and quarantine and dealing with that. But if that weren't here, we'd still be dealing with a bunch of people that are always going under, business is always failing, and they're kind of month to month. I mean, I don't know the stats right this second. I know I posted them at some point, but the amount of businesses that fail is like incredible. And so this guy created this 10,000 year clock. Bezos invested in the land and the mountain, and their goal is to make it powered by sunlight, something that will stand the test of time. And I don't know what he's going to do. I guess he's going to put in some kind of trust or will that this land and mountain, no matter who it passes down to in his kids, never get sold, right? Else someone will basically bulldoze it or something. But it just made me think long term. And the question I asked myself is, if the clock can keep going for 10,000 years, what project could we start right now or keep going that we're already doing that could run 10,000 years? And that question actually helped me just come to a little more clarity on what I'm truly, truly passionate about. Because if you're running, let's say, three different businesses right now, and I say three different businesses because you might be doing three different things. You might be doing two different things. Hell, you might be doing four different things. You could have a side gig, a night job, a weekend job. You could be running as an entrepreneur, you're trying to launch two things at once. Maybe one is for passion, your passion project, and the other is for money. One's making money, one's not. But when I asked myself, if the clock can keep going for 10,000 years, what project could I start or do or continue running that could run for 10,000 years? And immediately in my mind, the Cheryl Show focused on enhancing social connectedness came to mind, because I thought, the thing is though, even though I have thought out a few years, I'm not thinking long enough, because then it made me say, like, what project that I'm working on, and you don't have to be this long-term thinker. You don't have to be this much of a long-term thinker, but it does make you stop for a minute and think about what you're doing, what you're implementing, how you're running your business, and think beyond yourself for a minute. If the clock can go 10,000 years, so can a project that I'm working on. So if I take this into my example, in the Cheryl Show, enhancing social connectedness, how could I build it? Infrastructure, technology, spreading the message, having guests, building some type of platform or message, maybe just a message, because platforms I think will come and go, and where it's housed will come and go. But the message, how could that project last 10,000 years and require future generations to finish? That was the real sentence that made me think, what could you start now that would require future generations to finish? So I don't know the complete answer to that right now for me, because I need to think about this, and I need to actually dedicate time to think about it, not just say I'm going to think about it and not think about it. sit down and think about it and at least just jot down a lot of ideas. And something of those ideas will pop out. And then I'll start implementing that. And so when Jeff Bezos actually decided in 1989, where he was communicating with this gentleman and decided to put that $42 million into this investment, at that time is about the time that he wrote the letter to shareholders, the 1997 letter to shareholders, where he had an entire section about long-term goals. And he basically said in there that his long-term goals are that he's customer obsessed and customer focused to the point that that is his number one long-term goal. And even so much that he will sacrifice profits and he even told investors, do not invest in Amazon if you are not also thinking in a long-term, because this is how I'm thinking, which means we're going to have stock drops. We're going to have valuations that aren't what Wall Street sees. We're going to, you know, maybe take a couple years. So one of the things I wanted to mention is that Apple saw Amazon doing this long-term thinking. Like one of the things that they did to implement long-term thinking is that they stopped doing quarterly earnings by product. And Apple implemented that. They didn't start off thinking long-term. They were short-term, hyper-focused on giving Wall Street and investors exactly what they wanted, which is monthly updates per product, quarterly earnings per product. This is like literally obsessed with the short-term, right? 1 year or less, so that the value of the company would be higher, higher, higher. They implemented a long-term thinking after they started. And how it affected them was, it was in November 2018, they decided to follow the footsteps of Amazon and implement long-term thinking. And they declared to Wall Street that they would no longer be putting out quarterly earnings, because they felt that that did not represent the health of a product. They would do annual. And so what happened is when they announced it, their stock went down 6.6% and they lost $71 billion that day, which is multiple companies hitting the dirt, you know, base planning, going out of business. That's the value of multiple large companies right now, is how much they dropped and lost $71 billion that day that they announced they were no longer going to provide quarterly earnings. It didn't represent the health of a product. Quarterly earnings per product, only quarterly earnings as a whole. And because of that, they dropped 6.6%, which was $72 billion. So it was a huge, huge loss. And they basically had to be, you know, one with the universe in representing themselves, saying, this is a short-term thing. You're running, Wall Street runs on short-term. What is the thing they say? Wall Street, the stock market is a voting system in the short-term, and it's a weighing system in the long term. Anyway, I've heard that. I'm not a stock person, but I do read. So that was an interesting thing where someone's following the footsteps. And so there's more companies following the footsteps of long-term thinking. But the question is like, how? But for me, I thought that how I could relate it, and this is what I wanted to pop back to, is just how can we implement this in our small little mediocre, just starting out, we don't have a huge market share. I'm saying that because there's a lot of online businesses and consulting companies and service companies, and everyone's selling something, and you might think of yourself as really tiny. And we are, right? Because if you had the true market share of 300 million people, you know, you'd be, you know, you might not be in this group anyway. So the question is, how can I implement this in my company, no matter how small, medium, or large? And I like the question that I'm sitting with, which is, what can I start that the future generations can finish? Which means I need to put a little more thought into my message. Now, my brand, I'm going to say this and then I'm going to have a caveat. My message, my brand, my thinking, my delivery, my dispersing of information, the platform it goes out on, the consistency it goes out on. Now, do you see a little bit of the idea of less is more? you realize that less is got to be more, because you cannot be on 24/7, respond 24/7, post 1,000 times a day or week or month, and do it for, you know, 100 years. You have to have a less is more, more impactful, more value, more consistent kind of mentality, and then have some real long-term goals, like what can my kids, and maybe it's not the kids, but what can my customer, what value will they get? What message will they hear and remember? And what can someone in the future finish what I started? Anyway, I'm really sitting with that because I know that this is what I'm going for with the Cheryl Show and enhancing social connectedness. I already know that. I just didn't realize how to implement and how to think about it. So with the marketing, I had something happen this past week where the consistency and long-term strategies and planning of even this group, and how no matter what's happening in my life, I'm going live on Wednesdays. No matter what's going on, I'm sending the emails. I'm not inundating everyone in this group. I mean, there's some people in this group that probably don't see these messages that I'm going live. And it's because I don't fill the group full of like nonstop stuff. On the other hand, I've got a lot of people asking me, can I just go public and share this on LinkedIn? So I've been approved for LinkedIn Live. They want me to just start doing these kind of things on LinkedIn. And my point is, so then you're asking yourself, so what do I do? So here's what you do. Customer loyalty over profits. What decision can you make that would make your business stronger over the next 3 years, 7 years, or 100 years? That would be like when we're not around. And what are your company's long-term goals? And if you guys have a long-term goal, I want you to drop a comment. Like, what is your long-term goal? I will tell you one of my long-term goals with the show, the Cheryl Show. And it would just kind of popped out one day when I don't know, maybe it was my daughter or someone was like, what's your point? What is the purpose of what you're doing, Mom? And it was like, I want, when someone goes to Google or whatever search engine takes over within the next 100 years, whatever, it will all be somehow Google content will absorb into whatever transpires in the future on the internet. When someone searches enhancing social connectedness, I will be the one that pops up, because the essence of it is to stop suicide, is to let people know they're not alone, is to help, is to share, be vulnerable, be open, be transparent. I just want, that's just something that popped up. That it might sound ego and selfish, but basically when you Google enhancing social connectedness, when, now that's like a long word also. Some people are like, who's gonna ever Google that? And I'm like, maybe no one, but it is, the mental health of society is the most important thing that we could focus on if you were interested in something like that. And that's just something that I've chosen. So what decision can we make that makes our business stronger in 3 years, 7 years, or 100 years? Seriously, what technology, what platform, what message, what delivery, what letter to your shareholders or employees? What are you incentivizing your employees with that keeps them like in a long-term mentality, or your contractors? What are your company's long-term goals? Drop one. And I'm gonna tell you another one on my marketing company, that one of my long-term goals. And how can I incentivize employees on the long-term? So let me just go back to the story. So someone has been watching, not in the group, someone has been watching my consistency and basically reached out, had a meeting with this person, and am launching into literally a national marketing venture that is, frankly, my dream marketing client. It's a dream marketing client. And I really had never, you know, I hadn't really like written in my mind, this is my dream marketing client. And it was because of the consistency and my constant, like, kind of long-term thinking of like, this is what it boiled down to. This is what it boiled down to him. I can see that you're not going away. I can see that you're in it for the long haul. This is what he got. This is the message he got. So if I could pull everything I'm saying down to one thing, it's this. If people who want to hire you believe that you are not in it for the short term, or you're just in it to win it and you're out, you know, you're just like, sell as much as you can for the next 30 days and you're like, whew, I'm going to get out of that business. If you look like you are not going away, you, this is something you're going to do for a long time, then they want to connect with you. They want to be partnered with you. They want to build something with you. And this doesn't mean that your life needs to completely revolve around business and you have no social life, no vacations, and no fun. It just means that maybe you end up linking up with people that wouldn't have looked at you or considered partnering or doing something with you if they thought that, you know, you're really not in this for the long term. And so how do people know whether you're in it for the long term? That's the question, right? So you might say, well, how do I let people know that I'm in it for the long term? Tell them. One person I talked to on the phone, I think he said something and I said, well, I'm not doing this for just like the next month. Like, this is something I'm going to be doing forever. And it was regarding the Sheryl Show. I'm like, this is something I'm going to do forever. When the reason it took me so long to decide when I'm going to start going live and what day and time is because I'm planning to go indefinitely until at some point I turn it into some version of a show that is beyond Facebook, but it will still be indefinite. And so with that in mind, he was like, I think we need to talk. And so I don't know. So I guess I could boil this down to letting your customers know, letting your clients know, and letting potential people who want to invest in you know that you're in it for the long term. And what does that mean to you? And verbalizing it. That's it. What do you guys think? Let me know what your thoughts are. Let me know what your long-term goals are. And drop a comment, whatever social platform you're watching this, drop a comment of your long-term goal in your business and a long-term goal personally, and maybe you can create something that can do both of them. And that's my hope. Hope you guys got a lot out of today, because long-term goals and thinkings, people think business plan, but this is kind of a different thing. We're going to think about creating our version of a 10,000 year clock. So I look forward to hearing all the 10,000 year clock ideas. All right, guys, next week is going to be really interesting. It's called your flywheel. And if you don't know what a flywheel is, check out next week, because you will learn how to create your flywheel, which will help your business. All right. I will see you guys later.